In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this handy pouch, which straps around the front cover of a journal. It's got pockets on the front for your mobile phone or for pens, and there's a handy zip section where you can keep more pens and pencils or anything you like to keep you organised. So let's take a look at the list of materials you need, and then we'll get sewing. So this is my outer fabric, and I've already fused some foam to the wrong side of that. I've cut out the backing fabric, two pieces of lining fabric, and then these are my pocket pieces. So let's start with the pockets. If you've got a larger piece of fabric, you could use one piece and fold it in half. But if you're using scraps like I have, I'm going to sew these two pieces right sides together, just across the tops. And I'm just using a 1/4 inch seam allowance. You can use the edge of your presser foot as a guide if you wish. That's not set in stone that it has to be 1/4 inch. And we'll fold these in half back on themselves. So with the seam right across the top, I'm then going to top stitch. And that helps to keep the layers together, but it also looks nice and neat as well. So I can use a longer stitch on my sewing machine. So, right, now if I take the fabric that has the foam on the back of it, I'm going to put the larger pocket over the top. And I'm going to sew straight down the centre, and that's going to divide this into two pockets. Now, this is entirely up to you. You could have one line along the centre, two pockets. You could make smaller lines, so you've got pen pockets. You could leave it as one large pocket, depends what you're going to use them for. Or if you wanted to slip a mobile phone in here, then maybe move the stitch line over to one side, so you've got a pen at one side and more room to put your phone in that side. So it's kind of bespoke, it's however you want it to be. So again, all the way down the centre. I've just marked with a friction pen, and that means that when I iron this now, the mark will disappear. But do test your fabric if you're going to use a friction pen, because sometimes they can stain or they can bleach the fabrics. Then I'm going to put the smaller pocket on the top. Like so. And I'm just going to put a few stitches in the sides just to hold that in place while I can construct the rest of the pouch. Just over the top of the pockets and a few stitches across the bottom. Don't have to sew all the way around. And down this side. So that's how we're looking. Then we're going to take the zip and sew this right sides down to the right hand side. So I like to move the slider right out of the way, which is why I go for zips that are longer than I need them to be, because they're easier to sew in. And with a zip with a nylon coil like these, you can just chop it down to size afterwards. So you could put the zipper foot on your sewing machine if you wish. It's not always necessary. and I'm sewing quite close to the edge of the zip. Now normally I'd sew halfway along the zip tape, but because I'm sewing through the foam, it makes it easier to fold the zip back. You'll see what I mean later on. Oops. So there's the zip on one side. Then I'll take the second side, which is in effect the back of my pouch. And I'm going to sew this along the opposite side of the zip. So I like to sew from the zip side so I can see exactly where I'm going. And just make sure that I've lined up the edges of the pouch and the backing. And so. So I've got two pieces that look like that. And we also need to put the elastic on at this point. Now, as you're measuring the elastic to go around your journal, don't have it too tight because your book will bend. But it just needs to have a little bit of give in there. So I'm just going to mark the centre of the top and the bottom of the front. And the elastic is going to be sewn facing inwards over that central mark on both sides. So make sure that's not twisted. And this is inside the seam allowance, so it's just a holding stitch, so sew quite close to the edge. Then we'll take the two lining pieces, and these are going to be sewn to the opposite side of the zip. So I'm sewing now from the side that I've already sewn because I can see where the stitches are, and I need to sew over the exact same stitch line. So that's the outside of my journal cover. So the zip's sandwiched in between the front and the back. And exactly the same on the lining. So the zip's actually inside the seam here. Next thing we need to do is to fold the lining pieces together and the outer pieces together. And we're going to sew all the way around the edge, but leave a gap in the bottom of the lining side so I can turn it the right side out. Now make sure when you're sewing around this part, in fact we'll tuck this inside the pocket because I don't want to sew over the top of the elastic, so we'll move that out of the way. And because the zip is like, it's like an H shape, when I come to sew towards the lining, I'm going to push the zip towards the lining. Now at the moment my zip's too long, so I'll undo that slightly, and I'm going to hand sew just over the top of the zip to keep it closed. That's going to make it easier to sew in. It's not going to open up as I'm sewing around the bag, basically. So just a few stitches to hold it. And then I can cut off the end of the zip. Make sure the zip's open while you're sewing around. And we'll sew all around the edge. Don't forget to leave that turning gap. Then I'll snip across the corners to cut down on the bulk when I turn it the right side out. Then we'll turn the whole thing through. This is where you need to leave the zip open. So just push out those corners. So I'll give that a press. The elastic can now go to the back of the journal. The opening, if you pull the sides open, the seams will fold inwards, so we'll sew straight across here, and then we're finished. So all I need to do now is to push the lining inside, close the zip, and then this can go around my notebook. So I hope you enjoy the tutorial, and I hope you enjoy making yours.